Hey, what's up, guys? Just wanted to check in. I've had some messages on update on what's next on the Boost build. So today, we're going to add on a Seatco seat cover. And this thing's going to look pretty good. It's got a nice touch. 92 from 92 Motorsports. I'm a dealer as well, so if you guys want one, hit me up. I can help you out. We'll get to it. Probably won't video the entire thing. It'll be pretty boring with taking out some staples, but I'll update later. So, still plugging away at these staples in the seat. All I've got is just a small flathead screwdriver, prying them out. I'm sure if you went and got a fancy staple remover or something, then it'd go by a little faster, but this isn't bad. Take a little elbow grease. To replace them, I went down to Harbor Freight, picked up a Banks 20 gauge 7/16 wide crown stapler. Well, it's a little bit bigger than what Seatco is calling for. They're calling for quarter inch staples, but I guess we'll see how this goes. Just give it a little more surface area. I think it's gonna be fine. So that's all they had. That's what I went with. So see how it goes. Touch back in a little bit. Okay, here we go. Stock seat cover. It's all loose. We're gonna install this Seatco. I'm saying I went down Harbor Freight, picked up a brown, it's a Banks 20 gauge wide crown staple. Staples are 7/16 by 3/8, a little bit bigger than what they're calling for, but I think we're gonna be just fine. So here we go. This is the first one I've done yet, so bear with me. Get the rear on. Okay, we've got three in the rear. So you're gonna put in a few and then have to just keep re-tightening and pulling the seat cover around. So your first few are gonna get it perfect. Just gonna kind of get it in place, get it to hold itself, and then just keep working your way around. Working on some of these kinks.
Everything in moderation. except for popcorn. Popcorn doesn't count.
Already pretty flat. It's got a few waves in it, so keep working at it, but pretty easy. This thing's got a lot more grip. That's pretty good. Looks badass. You got a 3-digit number that you can put up here too, whatever you pick. So I'm just gonna keep going around here and stapling this thing down, and I'll show you the finished product. All right, here we go. Finished up with the Seco seat cover. I threw in probably a little overboard on staples, but I don't want it to go nowhere. The Harbor Freight gun worked good. Set at 90 PSI, $35, hard to beat. 7/16 by 3/8 staples, a little extra surface area. It worked out good. Seat cover. Did a couple staples on the rear here first, stretched it over to the front, and then just kept working it over on itself, just kept stapling down. So it works out pretty well. You don't have to beat on this thing or stretch it out. So goes on nice, looks even better. Let's see what it looks like on the sled. There you have it. Turquoise matches really well. A lot grippier, better control of the sled. Plus they look badass too. Hit me up if you wanna get a seat cover for yourself from Seco and help you out. 92 Motorsports, for riders by a rider.